couples across Central Florida are just hours from making history. But with a ban on gay marriage set to expire at midnight, we found out a last-minute legal challenge could put those unions in jeopardy in Orange and maybe other counties. At this hour, we are still monitoring an emergency motion to block same-sex marriages in Orange County.
Attorneys opposing the marriage licenses asked to be heard before the stay is lifted tonight at midnight. But Channel 9's Shannon Butler found out this last-ditch effort is headed to the state Supreme Court now. And Shannon, what does this mean then for same-sex couples headed the clerk's office tomorrow morning?
Well, we don't know yet. Right now, those licenses and that ceremony at City Hall will go on as planned. Now, here's the issue. The Florida Family Policy Council filed a motion to block the same-sex marriages in Orange County. They named both Judge Bob LeBlanc and Mayor Buddy Dyer. Both are performing ceremonies tomorrow. Well, the chief judge here in Orange County then recused the entire Ninth Circuit. Then the lawyers removed the judge's name, but there was no reversal. Now that motion is at the Supreme Court level to make a decision what circuit court should now hear the motion. Now, at this late hour, we don't think there is going to be a hearing tonight, and there will likely not be one before those 9 a.m. ceremonies at City Hall tomorrow. The Florida Family Council says this fight is long from over.
Today's not the end. Tomorrow's not the end of this. The Supreme Court still has the final say-so. Should the Supreme Court rule for states' rights, I think you're going to see immediately the Florida Marriage Amendment reinvigorated in terms of its authority.
Now, we don't know if the Supreme Court will look at this motion. We haven't heard from them. This has just come down in the last half an hour or so. We don't know if they'll decide on the issue or they'll send it to another circuit. These details are still coming in. We will, of course, keep you posted. In the newsroom, Shannon Butler, Channel 9 Eyewitness News.
A lot of folks will be watching. Meanwhile, dozens of same-sex couples in Osceola County are also waiting to tie the knot just after midnight.
The county clerk is opening the courthouse at midnight to start issuing marriage licenses. Channel 9's Ryan Hughes spoke to the clerk today, and Ryan, he told you he is prepared.
Marty, he said he'll be here all night ready to wed anyone who walks through the doors. The Osceola County Clerk of Court plans to be the first person to officiate a same-sex wedding just after the clock strikes midnight. Armando Ramirez calls it his duty.
I am compelled to follow the law. I cannot impose my own personal religious views on the population.
Part of that population applied to marry here. This courthouse received 30 applications from gay couples, but there's no word how many will show up when the law allows at 12:01 a.m. tomorrow. Earlier today, Miami-Dade County became the first place in Florida to allow same-sex couples to marry half a day before a gay marriage ban that was ruled unconstitutional was lifted statewide.
I was elected by the people of Osceola County to do my job, and that is to follow the Constitution of the United States. The Constitution of the state of Florida.
We're told there's a chapel inside the courthouse where the ceremonies will be performed. Newly elected Osceola County Commissioner Cheryl Grebe will be one of the first to wed her longtime partner. Congressman Alan Grayson's office said he'll serve as ring bearer at the late night ceremony. Now, the courthouse behind me opens tonight at 11 o'clock for reporters. Then the general public will be permitted to enter shortly after that. Reporting live tonight in Kissimmee in Osceola County, I'm Ryan Hughes, Channel 9 Eyewitness News.
And we have posted a complete list of information on where to get marriage licenses in Central Florida. You'll find it in the web link section of WFTV.com. We'll also have a crew monitoring local clerks of court and the state Supreme Court for any last-minute changes ahead of tomorrow's ceremonies. Count on us for a live report tonight on Eyewitness.